How's it going, folks? There's a part in the Bible, in the New Testament, that I was looking over, and I kind of was thinking about it, like, what does it mean? And I wanted to share it, because it's something that I've heard for a long time during my life, being exposed to, like, this verse. And it's something that Jesus says. It comes in Matthew chapter 6, beginning in verse 19. It says, "Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." Okay, so I was thinking about it, and I'm like, that last part in particular, "For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also," it's verse 21. What does that mean? I thought about it for a long time, and I think in this verse, in this speech, Jesus is basically saying where your treasure is, or that which you value, will be your longing in life. So what you put value at is what you will inevitably long for. And I was thinking about it in the context of life, and a lot of times we long for things, we want things, which rust consumes, which moths eat. It's sort of a general way of saying we desire things which are fleeting, or things which pass away and aren't eternal. And it's inevitable as humans, as human beings, that we long for things that we feel are missing in our life, and we try to make up for things. So it's inevitable that we will long for something, that we will have desires. It's just that we ought to long for the right things and the rewarding things, the things which don't degenerate. And I think that's what is meant by storing up for yourselves treasures in heaven. Because you store up these things that are values. Things which, you know, the cliche goes, the truly valuable in life is free. Like, love of family, things which you can't put a price on, memories, happiness, things like that. And ultimately, I would think faith and objects of faith, the values which we put in our lives, the values of being a good person or being a better person, virtues, living according to virtues the best that we can, in spite of the struggles that we may have. That's what it means to store up things in heaven, because those things are of an eternal fabric, and they don't pass away. They don't get stolen by thieves or rusted or eaten by moths. So I just wanted to share that part because, like, I always wondered, like, what Jesus meant by that. So